joining us here on Newswell Brooklyn on this Christmas Eve. I'm Michelle Devone, and Merry Christmas to all our viewers. Guess what? It's crunch time for those thousands of Brooklynites hitting the stores today to buy those critical last-minute gifts. You really waited last minute. Newswell Brooklyn reporter Hannah Klieger is at the Kings Plaza Mall to show us how many people are busy shopping to make this a very special Christmas.
Was the night before Christmas, and all through the mall, hundreds of shoppers were having a ball.
I like the holiday rush, seeing a lot of people in the mall doing that rush. I just love it. I like last minute shopping.
Looking for deals on last minute gifts, racing through stores, so nimble and swift.
Every year on Christmas Eve, we go, we take a photo with Santa. So we tell Santa what we want, so he brings it that night.
Macy's and Rainbow and Best Buy and more. So many options for presents galore.
It's better to give than to receive, because that's what Christmas is about.
To bring that smile to a loved one's face, they're out here shopping as though running a race.
We try to teach our son to give. That's why he said he only wants a skateboard, because he wants to make sure all the kids get something from Santa for Christmas.
Clothing and beauty and gadgets and toys for grandparents, friends, little girls and little boys.
This is the day that we choose to celebrate the birth of Christ. So for that reason, it's mostly important for us and for my children.
The atmosphere cheerful, merry and bright. They're excited to see Santa and his reindeer tonight.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Open till 7 as the night draws near, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be here. Waiting to see Santa and all of his elves at Kings Plaza Mall, Hannah Klieger, News 12.
Who knew she's a poet?
Very nice.
All right, Darryl.
Very nice. Well, that's one person that's definitely in the holiday spirit. I hope
Absolutely.
You have all of your holiday shopping taken care of. Let's get to some
Mine's
of the important stuff. Yours is on your head. Okay. We're taking a look at what we can expect out there for Christmas Eve. Believe it or not, a mostly clear sky is in our forecast. It will be a cold one. Temperatures either side of 32 degrees. That's the point of freezing, so make sure that you are dressing to be warm. Outdoors right now, you can see we're looking at the Canarsie Roof Cam. 39 degrees is what we're looking at this location. Humidity is at 57%, west winds at about 7 miles per hour. Take a look at the temperatures across Kings County, Brooklyn. Whole bunch of 43s out there. Popular number. We got those winds coming in from the west. Anywhere from 17 to 19 miles per hour. We got some gust out there over the past hour. We saw some gusts in the 20 mile an hour range. As a result, it feels like 5-10 degrees colder outdoors there, so make sure you're dressing for these numbers before heading out. Now, we were looking at some precipitation. Yes, we had some earlier in this day. In the city, primarily just rain, maybe a few wet snowflakes north and west. It was a little bit of an accumulation, and those are the locations well north and well west that you have to go in the higher elevations to see anything that looks like it might be a white Christmas. We did get some sun very late, mixed in with some clouds, not a whole lot out there. A clearing sky will be taking over as we go through the overnight, and we are looking at the future cast. You can see these temperatures will continue to peel back, and we're going to see the early morning temperatures in the lower 30s, unfortunately, because of winds coming in about 5 to 10 miles per hour from a northwest direction. It's going to feel a bit colder than that, so it's going to feel like it's in the 20s. Daytime highs, we'll see upper 30s and low, maybe the middle 40s, special locations like Red Hook, sun and clouds, northwest winds 5 to 10 miles per hour. It's going to be a cold day, but it's going to be a dry day. Merry Christmas to everybody. Have a great time, but please be safe.
Thank you, Darryl. And as part of the holiday celebrations, well, some people are wearing hats like me, but Italian-American families in our borough will indulge in a wide selection of seafood this evening, and it's part of the Feast of the Seven Fishes. Octopus Garden on Avenue U was busy all day as people came in to select the freshest fish. Also on the menu, lobster, clams, and octopus. The tradition dates back to Italy, where people had to abstain from meat before a feast day. Here in Brooklyn, it's all about keeping the custom alive.
Therefore, you're having only fish for this holiday. And we kept up with the tradition. The seven fish thing, I don't know what that came from. Someone made it up, and they said, we're going to have at least seven fishes.
It can take hours to cook all that food, but that is all part of the fun.
So they just come up.
Around the world now to Bethlehem, where worshipers are celebrating the Christmas holiday. The city in the West Bank near Jerusalem is believed to be the site of Jesus' birth. And it's beautiful and lit up tonight. A large tree in the public square known as Menger Square serving as the center of the festivities. Thousands attending midnight mass as well. Merry Christmas. Meanwhile, down in our nation's capital, the national Christmas tree is back open for business. The site was closed last week after a man damaged it trying to climb it. And because of the government shutdown, the National Park Service was unable to keep it open. However, the National Park Foundation stepped in to provide the support it needed. It'll remain open until January 1st. And of course, we still want to see how you're showing off your holiday cheer. Show us those festive pictures. All you have to do is upload them to news12.com or post them to social media using the hashtag BKHolidays. 12 is on crime now, and a woman slashed overnight in Crown Heights. Police say a woman in her 20s was outside this building at Park Place and New York Avenue around 1:30 this morning when the suspect walked up and attacked her with a sharp object. She was rushed to a nearby hospital in stable condition. And up in the Bronx, check this out. A News 12 viewer sharing this video of someone stealing a package right from their home in broad daylight. This was in the Belmont neighborhood, and police say this happened Thursday around 3 in the afternoon. The thief seen walking up to the house, ringing the doorbell, and making off with that package when nobody answered. If you have any information that can help police in either of these cases, you're asked to call Crime Stoppers. The number is 1-800-577-TIPS. And as we get ready to ring in 2019, we're counting down the most viewed stories of the past year on news12.com. Story number 8 goes hand in hand with number 9 on our list. 17-year-old Justin De La Parra charged with murder in the shooting of another teen over the summer in Bed-Stuy. 16-year-old Latrell Brown shot to death on McCone Street in the middle of the afternoon on July 11th. And nearby surveillance video capturing the violence. Police say they believe the two teens had an argument before the shooting. You can watch the full story right now on news12.com and keep checking in. We're adding one story a day, revealing the most watched story of 2018 on New Year's Eve. And it's time for a look at what's ahead on News 12 Nightside. The kids are off from school. It's winter vacation, and you're not sure what to do to keep them busy. Well, News 12 Nicole Ryan may have the answer you've been searching for. Plus, paying it forward, how a Brooklyn man is making sure the homeless in our borough are taken care of this Christmas. We're headed to Brownsville for this heartwarming story. All this and much more coming up at 7:30 this evening on News 12 Nightside. 12 is now in business as the once popular children's chain Gymboree is reportedly gearing up to file for bankruptcy protection. The Wall Street Journal says the retailer is looking for a loan to keep some of its stores open while it searches for a buyer. If Gymboree does file for Chapter 11, it would likely close the majority of its 900 locations. The company also took bankruptcy action last year, closing more than 360 stores. Where will all the kids play in winter? All right, we're turning now to the immigration crisis. A source says a temporary facility in Texas set up to house children who showed up unaccompanied at the border will close down after the final child is released. And that source says the complex is no longer accepting kids and will end operations as soon as the last person there is either released to a sponsor or another facility run by the Office of Refugee Resettlement. Around the world now to Italy, where Europe's most active volcano is erupting. As we speak, Mount Etna blew its top today, setting off a 3.3 magnitude earthquake and the closure of Sicily's main airport. You can see clouds of billowing smoke, ash spewing thousands of feet into the air. Italian scientists say there has also been a gradual increase in activity at the volcano over the last month. 12 is on health now. And as a new study suggests that parents sleep less and drink more and deal with more holiday stress than adults who don't have kids. And this report surveyed 1,000 adults and teens and found that 53% of American parents will lose sleep over the holidays due to stress compared to 23% of non-parents. The study also found 67% of parents will drink more over the holidays compared to 54% of non-parents. And the CEO of Sleep Cycle, which issued the report, says the lack of sleep is to blame for parents falling back on bad habits. And while some say coffee is an acquired taste, a new study suggests otherwise and says that your love of Java might start much earlier. Scientists at Northwestern University's Feinberg School of Medicine found a link between genetics and how people perceive different tastes. The research suggests that evolution favored people with a stronger tolerance to bitter food and drinks like coffee, helping researchers explain why many of us enjoy that bitter pick-me-up more than others.
Canarsie, you're watching News 12 Brooklyn, as local news gets.